Hello, and welcome to this short introduction to GASB 100, Accounting Changes and Error Corrections for GAAP Basis Governments. My name is Vivian Vandenberg, Assistant Audit Manager with the Local Government Support Team here at the Office of the Washington State Auditor, and the lead on the implementation of GASB 100 for Washington State Governments. In today's brief session, we'll cover the 5 W's of GASB 100. What is the change? Why are things changing? Whom is this affecting? When will the change be effective? And where will this have an effect? So let's get started. GASB 100 is the new accounting standard that addresses accounting and financial reporting for accounting changes and error corrections. The standard covers 3 accounting changes: changes in accounting principle, changes to or within the reporting entity, and changes in accounting estimates. The standard also identifies and covers error corrections. I'm now going to briefly explain each of the topics that are covered by this GASB. The first one we'll cover is the changes in accounting principle. Now, this will cover cases that a government is switching from one generally accepted accounting principle to another, or they're simply adopting a new accounting standard. Changes in accounting principle are to be recognized retroactively. This means that the beginning net position or fund balance should be restated. The second topic we cover is the changes to or within the reporting entity. Now, this one covers many more situations than the previous, as you can see. Changes captured by this are as follows: the addition or removal of a fund that results from the movement of continuing operations within the primary government, including its blended component units. Another one covered by this is the change in a fund's presentation as major or non-major. This will be used in either scenario, which means if your funds are moving from non-major to major or vice versa. Other situations this accounting change captures are the removal or addition of a component unit from the government's financial reporting entity, as well as the change in a component unit's presentation as blended or discretely presented. When situations like this arise, they will be applied retroactively. In cases like this, it will appear as if the change occurred as of the beginning of the fiscal year, regardless of when the transaction or change actually occurred. The final accounting change covered by this GASB is changes in accounting estimates. In cases that the inputs to an accounting estimate are changed, that change will be covered by a change in accounting estimate. Note that this is specific to the inputs that are used to calculate the estimate, not the estimate just changing over time. From a financial statement perspective, these changes will be recognized prospectively. And the final topic covered by this GASB are the error corrections. As defined in the standard, an error correction is necessary when there's been a mathematical mistake, a mistake in the application of an accounting principle, or the oversight or misuse of facts that existed at the time the financial statements were issued. Error corrections are to be recognized retroactively. That means that the beginning net position or fund balance would be restated. So now that we've covered what the standard is, let's briefly discuss why the change is occurring. Over time, it had become clear to GASB that there was not a consistent application in the financial statements regarding these situations. This statement is truly intended to bring consistency to government financial statements by stating how these accounting changes and error corrections are reported and handled in the financial statements. The big question many have: does this change affect me? And the answer is yes. It affects all governments that have these types of transactions. Now, when will the change be effective? Well, for most of you, you're our local governments here in the state of Washington, and your fiscal year end is 12/31. So this change is effective for fiscal year of January 1st, 2024 through December 31st of 2024. Now, we do like to pay attention to our fiscal year end 6/30 governments and those that have a fiscal year end of 8/31. You can see those changes are listed here on the screen. So where will this have an effect to all of you? There are going to be some new bars codes coming out with this. We are retiring a code. We'll cover that here on the next slide. And there are also note disclosures. So the note disclosures will be intended to contain details regarding how the accounting changes or error corrections have impacted different reporting units or funds within your financial statements. There are narrative requirements as well as a display table. So here are the new BARS codes that are going to be available for these situations. We are separating out the prior period adjustment code, which is being retired, into three new codes: a separate one for change in accounting principle, change to or within the reporting entity, and error correction. You may be noticing here that the change in accounting estimate is not captured in the new codes that are going to be implemented with this standard. And that's because the application of changes in accounting estimate are applied prospectively in the period that the change occurred. And with that, no new BARS code is required for situations of this nature. And we'd like to just make sure that you stay tuned for what we are going to be publishing about note disclosures for GASB 100. I did mention that there is a narrative requirement as well as a displayed table that will be included in the note disclosure, but keep an eye out for this. We do plan on publishing something else soon as the statement is close to being more implemented. So now you may be asking, what's next? How do you get started? We always recommend that you go out and you read GASB Statement 100 to get a better idea about what you may have more questions on. And the second option we have here is just keep your eyes open for any training and workshops that we may have continued on the topic. If you go to our BARS and Annual Filing tab in our website, you will see the dropdown there is listed trainings and workshops. By visiting that, you'll be able to see what else we may have coming regarding GASB 100. And on that note, if you do need any additional information, we do encourage you to submit a help desk to our office or just go check out our website. Thanks for listening.